This is Eastern Neston, the Northamptonshire home of the Heskeths. It was built in 1710, and it might seem incongruous, but this stately home is the setting for the development of a brand new British motorcycle. Lord Hesketh was the power behind James Hunt's rise to fame and fortune. This is where Hesketh Racing built their cars and where they still rebuild and maintain Formula One engines today. Now it's here that the most promising motorcycle to have come out of Britain in the last 25 years has been born. The Hesketh is not simply another big prestige motorcycle with its British birthright as its only unique feature. It incorporates some thoroughly practical and down-to-earth qualities that the current crop of bike makers should be ashamed of themselves for not using. Relish the thought that we in Britain have, or shortly will have, our very own 1000cc 90-degree V-twin employing twin overhead cams, electronic ignition, a 5-speed gearbox, 80% British-made components, and an electric starter. That was beautiful. It's really is a case of the iron fist and the velvet glove. It's as smooth as velvet, but the thing's as crisp as ice. But there's none of the revvy feel, the tension you get with a lot of the bigger Japanese machines. This thing's very high geared and it revs very slowly. It's the ideal thing for transcontinental cruising, really. Hesketh are claiming something like a top speed of 140 miles an hour of this. I would think they're about right. The design group decided to build a traditional, even classic motorcycle, but one that still offered all the advantages of modern motorcycling. For this reason, no kickstart crank is fitted, for example, but the engine is air-cooled in the best motorcycle traditions, despite the probable future disadvantages of mechanical noise, which water-cooled engines don't suffer. One interesting piece of equipment is the hydraulic clutch. It's a brainchild of the car-trained engineers on the team. And a V-twin was ordered from Westlake's, the engine designers, because only it was narrow enough, yet provided the right sort of power development. Wisely, Hesketh have decided to avoid the stupid race for sheer power that seems to be dominating the style of big machines from the leading makers just now. The bike itself is no lightweight at 506 pounds. A Honda CBX 1006 weighs 550, and a 900 Ducati V-twin weighs 480 pounds, but Hesketh are confident that they can lose some of their weight from the engine, which alone weighs 220 pounds. Unlike any other production machine, the Hesketh is equipped with a chain that operates under constant tension because of the positioning of the pivoted fork. This alone should reduce chain wear by at least 50 and probably up to 70%. The other special feature is the rear brake, which, unlike most motorcycles, does not lock the rear suspension up during hard braking. Where once horses were groomed, now high technology rules. These converted old stables now house the quality control laboratories where 15,000 pounds worth of test apparatus has been installed. Perhaps if the old British industry had done as much towards their future, Birmingham, Wolverhampton and Woolwich would still be turning out bikes now.
The gracious lifestyle of the aristocracy at home and the dirty fingernail technology of motorcycle engineering make an apparently ill-assorted partnership. But is it in fact so strange? Lord Hesketh, why did you first consider seriously building a motorcycle, considering your racing car background?
Well, we wanted to diversify. This is 2 years ago, because we're always rather worried about the racing car industry lasting. And we felt that a motorcycle made in this country with the right technology had a market waiting for it, and it's a market that's getting bigger. And the only thing we had to assume was that everyone was wrong, saying that you couldn't build a motorcycle in Great Britain. I think that we've conclusively proved that it's perfectly possible, and not that difficult, in fact.
But why the Italian brakes and the Japanese instruments?
Because the brakes were the best brakes that we could get in terms of performance and price, and that again applies to the Japanese instruments that are on it now.
But it's relatively easy enough to build a prototype, but your troubles surely are only just beginning when you try to get this into production.
Well, that's very, very true, and we are very aware of that, but I think that it's also fair to point out that this bike's been running for 12 months now. There are 8 of these, which are pre-production machines. This is not the traditional English one-off prototype that's been rolled out, and everyone says, here we are, we're going to take on the Japanese. We're not saying we're taking on the Japanese, we're going for the European bike market, super bike market, and I think that it's perfectly possible to do it, and I think that we can overcome any further problems by having a suitable partner who's got the industrial experience to make it properly.
And when will the first one be for sale, and how much will it cost?
Well, we very much hope that we will have them in the dealer's showrooms, admittedly in limited numbers, spring of next year. Price, it's got to compete against a BMW RSR and a Leopard Yotta.
Lord Hesketh, thank you very much.
Thank you.
What I'd really like to do is to ride a Hesketh to BMW in Munich, just to study the expression on the faces of some of their engineers.